I am the knight. And that is my story.
Okay. Okay. Who's next?
I want to go.
Not fully drunk.
No, I will go next. I am the miller, and this is my tale. Once upon a time, there was a rich old lady named Janya who was a carpenter and owned a big mansion. Within this big mansion, a room was rented to a student named Nicole. Of course, every rich old lady must have a handsome young husband, and so she did, and his name was Alan. Alan was very handsome with a muscular body as strong as a lion, so he wore a vest as dark as coal coupled with a flirtatious look in his eyes. One day, while Alan was in the garden, Nicole came by.
Hey, baby.
Gosh.
So you didn't make love to me?
Never! Leave me alone!
I just can't help myself. Stop. I have to have my way with you.
Oh my gosh, look, I don't want to look at you, touch you, squeeze you, or anything. Just leave me the heck alone.
I can't help myself. You're the sun in the sky to me, the light of my soul, the sugar to my tea, the bread to my butter, the tea to my pain.
Aw. That was kind of cute.
Thanks.
Now there was another woman who had her eyes on Alan named Abby. She was one of the parish clerks of the church and went around burning incense. One night, Abby decided to serenade Alan.
We're just ordinary people. We don't know which way to go.
One day while Johnny was away, Alan and Nicole devised a plan to trick her. If their plan worked, they would be able to sleep together all night. So, Nicole moved a day or two worth of food into her room. Alan told his wife that he hadn't seen Nicole in days and that she might be sick. So being concerned, Johnny went to check on Nicole.
Is everything alright? I just got a text message from God, and he said that there's a flood coming, like the one that Noah had.
Are you serious? Oh my God, what are we gonna do?
Okay, well here's what God said. I'll forward you a copy of the instructions.
Okay.
Okay, you must get large bathtubs for the three of us, and then we have to use them as boats to float in. Make sure you put enough food in each tub to last a day. Once you get them, you must tie each of them to the ceiling with rope where no one can spot them. Remember to put an axe in them so we can cut ourselves free from the house and float away like swans.
Okay.
One more thing, when we are waiting the flood in each of the tubs, we can't speak to each other or make a sound no matter what happens. We should be praying silently to ourselves because that's how God wants it. Now go. Peace.
I'm gone.
John is packing the tub. The night comes and they all get in them.
Guys, come on, everyone get in your tubs now.
In the tub I go.
Okay. While saying her prayers, Johnny falls asleep and begins snoring. Alan and Nicole then sneak out and start making sweet love.
Abby is now met by her friend.
Hey, have you seen Johnny lately?
I should not see her since it's Saturday. She probably is shopping at the Ross. She stayed there for a couple days at a time.
Oh, well, that's good, because tonight's my night to make Moo and Alan.
Oh, Alan, where are my Alan?
What do you want?
Just one kiss, my love.
Oh, go away. Leave me alone.
You better give me a kiss before I wake up your neighborhood.
Oh, fine, fine. Just one kiss.
Show him.
So Abby was upset that Alan disrespected her when she kissed his butt. So Abby thought of a plan for revenge and came back that night.
Oh, Alan, I brought you a golden ring. Can I have one more kiss?
Oh, crap. It's Abby.
What do we do? Wait, I got this. I'm coming! Let's get it on.
All the townspeople came and thought Janya was crazy, and this is how the story ends.